Hello, today we're going to have a look at the long tail. I've drawn a basic diagram on the board with sales up the side and rank along the bottom. If you imagine any market, be it books, films or music, the number one ranking product in that market is going to have the most sales. Number two is going to have the second most. And we can extrapolate that all the way along the line up to say number 50. And what we'll get is a line that looks like that, with gradually, as the rank goes down, sales decrease up to a point. Now I'd like you to imagine back before the internet was around. When you wanted to go to the cinema, you'd be able to go, but you would go to see one of the top films. Of course, the cinemas were limited. They had shelf space. They could only show a set amount of films because they only had a set amount of screens within the cinema. What's happened is, this gets truncated. It gets chopped off at a certain amount. Imagine buying music. Before the internet, you would often have to go down to your local shop to buy the music. When you got there, you'd be given a choice, often in terms of our number one, number two, and often down to about number 50. We'd be truncated, we'd be chopped off, and that would be the end of what we could buy. The growth of the internet has enabled something called the long tail to develop. Often, we'll think of places like Amazon, Play.com, and other internet sites that allow us to buy products that are maybe not so popular. What we can then do is take this line and move it along, and it carries along almost indefinitely. And as rank decreases, number 100, number 200, number 300, of course sales decrease at the same time, but there are still sales. These here are known as niches, very small amount of sales. This here, therefore, is a new market. Before the internet, you wouldn't be able to buy these products. Shops had shelf space, so you wouldn't be able to go and buy them. But with the growth of the internet, with unlimited shelf space, unlimited storage, what we can get is a market for these. A very, very small CD that might only sell one in every 5-6 months. You might still be able to buy that on Amazon or Play.com. Whereas in the traditional shop, of course, they wouldn't traditionally have it on the shelf. And this is the long tail. The long tail is this area here. It's an area that was underdeveloped before we had the internet. And the internet and the long tail come hand in hand.